Tanya, and welcome back to the channel, or welcome if you are new here. Today I'm back with a really awesome building collab that I'm actually doing with Rachel over at Fantasia. If you have not heard of her before, I mean, where have you been? But if you haven't, you should definitely go check her out. She is super close to 100,000 subscribers, and you should go subscribe. But anyway, we did a build collab where I built the outside of a house, and she's going to be furnishing it, so you should definitely go check that out. The link will be in the description down below, and it's a tidy Tudor. Oh my god, it's so cute. I'm like really excited about it because I've been wanting to build a Tudor style home for years, and it's always just been kind of scary. I don't know why. Like, every time I've tried, I'm just like, what am I doing? It looks like a box. How do I use these patterns? I just couldn't figure it out, and I was just like, you know what, I'm gonna build a Tudor today. This is gonna happen. I'm gonna figure it out. And I'm really happy with how it came out. So I hope you guys like it too. If you'd like to grab the shell, because this is just an unfurnished version, like I mentioned, you can download this on the gallery if you search Griffy or the hashtag Miss Griffy. Otherwise, you can download the furnished version, which I think you'd probably prefer. I believe her origin ID is Real Fantasia, but I mean, you should go watch the video first anyway. so link in the description. But anyway, we're messing around with the outside of the house. This is the basic shape. I tweak it a little bit, and there ends up being a weird thing where like some of the walls and the roof go missing, and I fix it later. It's all kinds of confusing, and I spent a really long time on this, and lots of landscaping. This is on the Shrieking Llama lot in Windenburg, which is that little bar kind of in the middle of a residential area. I thought this would be a nice place to place a adorable house because I've never built on that lot. For some reason, I tend to only build on lots that are originally supposed to be houses. So I was like, I've never built on this lot before. Let's build here. I made kind of a makeshift garage, and the entry level of the house is on the second floor because I thought that'd be kind of fun. And the closest thing I could come to, like, you know, like split leveling of some sort. So yeah, ignore what I'm trying to do here. I don't know what that was. I was like, I really want the stairs to have something else on this side. So I was trying to figure out how to make that work. We got rid of that in the end. I mean, we add a little bit of an extra area over here, but we didn't keep the weird deck area. It's just the staircase, which I almost never do stuff like that. There's always some kind of deck. So that was definitely different. And makeshift fireplaces are a must in builds for me. I just, so much fun. But yeah, I don't know. I'm very proud of this build, and I'm not usually that proud of builds. I feel like I say that in a lot of my videos, but I absolutely love how this came out. Because I guess it's because I've just been so afraid of building Tudors before, and I think I achieved the style. I think maybe, I don't know, you guys tell me. I'm sure you know more about building an architecture than I do. This is just kind of my interpretation. I looked at a lot of like inspiration photos, and I was like, I'm gonna go for it. I want to build something small. Let's just figure it out today. And here's that little fireplace. I did at one point try adding like a car in the driveway, but I kind of felt like it took away from the look of the house. You can put a fake car there if you want, though. I mean, maybe one day we'll have real cars in the game. That would be nice. Do you guys want cars in The Sims 4? I really want cars. I just want the basic animation like they had in The Sims 2. You don't have to like, because you're not going to have the same functionality as you did in The Sims 3 because we don't have an open world anyway. But I mean, it would be nice if your Sims could like go get in the car and back out and then disappear off the lot. I mean, I don't think that's too much to ask. I think that would be pretty cool. Also, maybe if we eventually got the ability to like work on the cars, kind of like we did with, what did that come with? The car you could work on in The Sims 3. Was it Fastlane? I think it might have been Fastlane. That it was like a fixer-upper car, and I thought that was a really cool idea. And I think your Sims could actually woohoo in that car too. You know, these are some very good ideas that we could potentially bring back into The Sims 4, maybe. I don't know why we're talking about Sims 3 to Sims 4 conversions on this house, but, you know, that's where my brain went, because I tend to ramble on these things. There's lots of garden areas. I wanted this to just be, like, a very, is lush the right word? Lush landscaping, and very kind of, like, in the woods, but I wanted to have some of the, I think those are birch trees, because there were some in the background that I think are from base game. Like, just, I wanted it to match its surroundings, look like this house belonged in this area. But these are the new ones that came with Cats and Dogs, which I think look amazing. So I just had to include them, and I felt like they still worked pretty well with the look I had in mind. We also put lots of ivy on this house because, I don't know, something about this style house, I'm like, there's going to be ivy growing on it. And I think a lot of the ivy and stuff came with Get Together, and like the Tudor style wallpapers came with Get Together. So I thought it was natural to like grab a lot of stuff from that pack. And definitely interested to see how this was decorated on the inside. I like really, once I built this, I was like, I really want to decorate it. Because I was like so excited about it. But of course I didn't. I left it unfurnished, and I'm excited to see how it comes out in the end. But so much greenery. This house actually ends up being super expensive unfurnished. I think it's like 50 or 60,000 simoleons, but there's no furniture in it. So, you know, that's kind of fun. definitely not affordable, but it also ends up being, I laid it out as two bedrooms. So it's probably two bedrooms. I mean, that might be changed in the final furnishings, but I laid it out that way. So if you download the unfurnished version or whatever, it is laid out to have two bedrooms, which are actually on the first floor because you enter on the second floor. And just fiddling with some door colors here. And I love those windows with those shutters. They are just so pretty. I was like, this is the build. I get to use the windows I stare at all the time. This is it. I get to use... We made a, like, fenced-in area here. It's a very small, like, side-slash-backyard. It just ends up having, like, a jungle gym for kids to play in. I imagined that's, like, the two bedrooms. I kind of imagined maybe, like, parents and one kid maybe lived here. I'm not sure. It could be also, like, a grandparent's house, and the extra bedroom is for, like, their grandchild that comes to stay with them on the weekends. I could see that. Even though my grandma's house looks nothing like this, it's not a Tudor-style house, it kind of reminds me of my grandma's house for some reason. I guess it's all the ivy, because she has a cobblestone chimney on the outside of her house, and it is covered in ivy all the way up. And so I guess I just think of her when I put lots of ivy on houses that have a lot of stone on them. Speaking of which, I would love to build her house sometime soon. I've been in the talks with my grandmother about her doing a video with me, so that might be coming soon. But this is just more in the chimney. I was trying to figure out how to get the stone to work proper, or like the bricks, because it had these corner bits. And then I found the same wallpaper in one that doesn't have those weird corners. Because those little weird corners are just kind of annoying, and I'm like, I don't know what to do with this. Like, why is this taking so long to figure out, and why doesn't it fit? So it's nice that that one had a version that doesn't have the like automatic corners, because a lot of times they don't quite work correctly, which is unfortunate. Also ended up getting rid of these sunflowers I spent ages placing to put this mailbox that came with Get Together, because it just matches so perfectly. And there's lots of floral all over this place. Lots of, well, not floral, flowers. There's not floral patterns anywhere though. And we end up, this is me trying to add a little bit of roof under, like, floor under the roof, because it was, like, when you were looking at the house from below, you could see into the roof, and it looked really weird and unrealistic, so I had to go ahead and fix that. But we're just placing some more windows. We end up putting this little circle one in the front of the house. I thought that looked pretty nice, and tons of ivy. There ends up being so much ivy all over this house. It's just, it's crawling up the walls. There it is. There ends up, the entire chimney pretty much is covered in it. We put some of the floral kind around as well. I just wanted everything to be very, like I said, I guess the word is lush. Although when I say lush, I think of bath bombs. So, I mean, maybe that's not the right word, but maybe it is. I don't know. Is that the right word? but we're placing some more bushes, just kind of placing stuff so it like fits in. And I guess it fits in, but I mean, like, looks like it belongs there. It's all like in its proper place, adding some more flowers and stuff, because I just can't add enough, apparently. I just need to add all of the flowers, so there's no space to do anything other than look at flowers. And we actually add a couple of gardening boxes in the yard as well, because I figured this would be a nice place for your Sims to do some gardening. It's a really pretty landscape, so I thought that could be nice. I didn't add it, and I don't know if maybe Rachel will, but like, I think if you had an artist sim, you could have an easel outside, and it would be a beautiful place to paint. Honestly, like, I would love to live in this house. If this house lived, if this house lived, if this house existed in real life, I would be so into the idea of moving in. Granted, I can't afford a house like this, but I really want it. It's just so nice, and it doesn't have a big yard, but, like, I want to get a dog, but, like, probably a small dog, and I would take it for long walks other places anyway, and it's such a cozy place. I want to move in. Doing more landscaping and painting, I tried to add some dirt to make it look more realistic. I feel like maybe it kind of didn't help as much. I'm not sure. Trying to soften the edges a little bit there as well. And I don't know what else I'm going to be doing for the next, like, 4 minutes in this. Oh, probably the floor plan. There's 4 more minutes of footage, and I'm like, the whole house is done. What do I have left? I didn't furnish this. So probably the floor plan, because I put down a basic floor plan, and I don't know if the floor or the wallpapers or anything are going to be changed. I would think so, probably, because I just kind of put something down to have an idea of where my head was at, and also because I thought placing the stairs might be kind of confusing since the house is kind of backwards where you enter on the second floor. So I kind of just wanted to put down what I thought a floor plan could be, and if she wants to change it, she definitely can. I would think somebody would, because, you know, you just kind of want to have fun with it. But this is just kind of what I was thinking, and I like it. I really like it. Like I said, I want to furnish this house too. It's so cute. But this is where we put the staircase. We end up having the kitchen and dining off to the side there. The staircase is in what I imagine would be the living room, and there's a tiny bathroom up in the front as well. Sorry, the footage is going actually pretty fast here. And then down here, I imagine this would be 2 bedrooms, and this one over here would be a, like, large master bedroom with a big ensuite. The biggest bathroom in the house is the ensuite. I thought, you know, spoiled the parents a little bit, and then there, I imagined that would be a bathroom over here. I don't know what you would put at the bottom of the stairs. It could be some kind of, like, rumpus room, or I don't know, just a place for, like, the kids to watch TV or play games, or just a second family room. It's total, or an office. It's just, like, open to interpretation, whatever you want to put, whatever anyone would want to put down there. So I'm excited to see what that room ends up being, actually. But here's all the excessive amounts of ivy on the fireplace. I actually skipped over that, but I had to size a lot of it down because it was kind of floating off the edges. So I fixed that, and we're adding some flowers throughout as well. And we added flower boxes on all the windows. I could have sworn I recorded that. Maybe I was just talking about something else while I was doing that. But I think they look really cute. I'm shrinking them all down now, though, because, you know, the scale down cheat, or it's not a cheat, is it? The scale down option now is amazing. I use it on everything. I just can't stop using it. It's, like, probably the best feature I feel like we've ever gotten in build mode. I'm just very excited about it, and I gotta use it every moment I can. Those are the flower boxes I was talking about. We actually add a roof on the bottom floor as well here. I thought that looked kind of cute, and change this railing to a half wall because I thought it would be nice to have, like, a little bit of stone right outside the door at the bottom, and a bench and stuff. Kind of like a makeshift deck, but it's not on a raised surface, if that makes sense. I don't know. Do I ever know what I'm talking about? But I think it looks really cute. We add this barrel of flowers and a bench. Did we make that barrel smaller? Yeah, it doesn't really fit in there. We had another plant behind it, I believe. But that is it. Coming to the end of the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. And if you haven't already, please go check out the furnishing of this video over on Rachel's channel. There is a link in the description down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you all next time. Bye, everybody.